Everybody, it is Professor Parrish, and we are on week 7 of English 122. We only have 2 weeks left of class, if you can believe it. So I'm recording this on Sunday, so if you've not gotten the assignments for Module 6 done, for week 6, make sure you have those. I've got one more video to do after this one. We've got this week's video, which is going to talk about week 7, which will seem much lighter in comparison to the other weeks, but you have a pretty big assignment on your hands with that final paper. And then week 8, you'll notice it will unlock on Sunday, July 24th. And so next Sunday, I'll have a video to talk about these final assignments, their due dates, and what to look forward to them. But that'll be posted next Sunday, July 24th, I'm pretty sure. So I want to talk about Module 7, which is Week 7's work. So obviously, you are still working on your final paper at this point. I should have your theses and topic and outlines for Paper 4 sent back to you by Monday or Tuesday this week. So hopefully all your topics will work out great. But the assignments for this week, other than this lecture video, there's no reading assignments. It's just the discussion forum, your MLA exam, the final exam for that, and then your final reading response. So talking about this week, so what we're doing this week is a little bit different than what we normally do. And so I'm actually going to, this should say Sunday, July 17th, but y'all know what I mean. So basically, you are uploading a draft of your final paper to this discussion forum. Now, this draft, as far as how long it needs to be, the drafts need to be halfway, so you need to have at least 4 full pages done. But the more you have, my rule of thumb is the more you have done, the more I can review. So if you get a lot of your paper done this week and you post it to the draft in this discussion forum, I can give you lots of feedback. If you include your works cited page, I can give you feedback on it. So you at least need to have 4 full pages completed by Sunday in your draft. But I would, if you have more, go ahead and post it, because that way you'll get more feedback. If you only turn in a page or 2 pages or 3 pages, I will still read it. But one, I won't have a lot of feedback to give you. And two, I will probably take off points in the discussion forum since you weren't meeting the instructions. So just keep a note of that. This part is probably the most important. Do not copy and paste your papers into the discussion forum. Please attach them as a PDF, a doc, or an RTF file. And to do that, it's pretty easy. You just basically, when you go down to create a post, you see this paperclip that says attach. You'll click that choose file button and you'll pick the file from your computer and attach it there, right? So if I picked a file from my computer, I could just do this look back one. We'll just do that and do that. Okay, so then you'll see that I could attach it here, or if I attach the wrong file, I'll just delete it and that's it. So just kind of keep track of attaching it and doing it that way, okay? And so then when you submit it, you'll have like a little submit blue button at the bottom and it will attach your paper. And that way I can click on it. That way, let me just kind of get out of that in a minute. But that way you can get out, you can pull up the paper as a student and peer review it, and so can I. So just make sure you attach your paper, and that way I can pull it up, I can make edits to it, I can see it. If you copy and paste it into the discussion forum, it will lose all of its formatting, and then I won't be able to check for grammar errors or formatting errors because it'll just be a big clump of text. So don't do that. Make sure you attach it to your papers. If my tutorial there isn't helpful, if you go to your student orientation file, it will show you how to attach as well. Or you can email online at sic.edu to get instructions as well. But please make sure you attach your papers. For the peer reviews, give your classmates constructive criticism. Specifically say what you liked and what you want them to improve on. No paper is perfect. My writing's not perfect. No one's papers are perfect. Everybody always has something they can improve on, whether it's grammar, whether it's MLA, whether it's the content. Everything has something that can be improved. So with that in mind, you can do it constructively and in a polite way. So instead of just saying, let me put it this way, if you just respond to a peer and say, good draft, I'm not going to give you points for that post because that's not enough. That doesn't help your classmate become a better writer. That just is like, okay, cool. Why was it good? What was good about it? What you need to do is say, hey, your draft was really good. I liked the way that you tied in your introduction to your body paragraphs. I liked all the detail you provided. I liked like when you gave this example. I want specifics. You're doing basically in this, you are reviewing 4 peer drafts, which is a lot. I will give you that. It's a lot. So I'm not going to ask you to be super detailed, but I do want you to give some specific examples. If you just say, good job, I'm not going to give you credit for that post. I want at least some specifics, all right? And if they need to improve on something, don't be afraid to tell them. I don't think that's being mean. I think it's being constructive. As long as you can say it in a polite, professional way, be totally fine. I've had students be like, hey, you might want to go back through the grammar in paragraphs 1 and 2 because there were some errors. Or I've had other students say, hey, you forgot your works cited page. Make sure you put that at the end of your paper. Or I've had some students say, hey, don't forget about the in-text citations. Like, you can be kind about it, but give them constructive feedback. And so the grades on this discussion forum are going to be based on everything listed above, your proper grammar and punctuation, and doing it by Sunday. So just be sure to read this, and I'm excited for you all to be able to read each other's work. I think that's a lot of fun. I don't usually do peer review discussion forums because they are a lot of work to sit there and read, especially since you have so much. But I do think they're helpful because not only will you get to see other classmates' work, but it may inspire you for your own writing. So that's pretty much it for that discussion forum. And then the final reading response is our last reading response. Yay! This one's actually pretty easy because I know you guys are going to be busy with working on your papers and working on the discussion forum this week. So this assignment's pretty straightforward. So for the last reading response, you just have to answer these questions. It should be about a page long, double spaced. 1, which genre of writing have you enjoyed the most? Short story, poetry, or drama, and why? 2, were there any genres that you were nervous about encountering in the course? Like, has your opinion changed? So I have a lot of students say that they were not excited about drama or poetry, and then their views either change or they don't change. And I want you to explain that. And then finally, of the genres that are your favorites, choose an example from the textbook and explain what makes it a good example. This can be an example you've used in previous reading responses. So if you really liked poetry, just pick a poem out of our textbook and explain to me why it's a good poem. Like, what makes that poem great? Since it's your favorite genre, what's a good example from our textbook and why do you like that example? So that's the reading response. It's pretty straightforward. And then finally, our MLA exam. You can't see it here because it's not technically offered yet, but the MLA exam, I'll just go ahead and pull it up here. Will it let me see it? It won't. I wish I could preview it, but it's not letting me. That's okay though. Basically, the MLA exam is going to be discussing, it's going to ask you some questions about MLA. So it's going to ask you to basically cite a textbook or show me how you would cite a journal. What's the formula for citing a journal? The formula for citing a textbook, which in text citation is correct. If you need help, the answers to most of these questions on the exam are in the MLA citation presentation. This presentation gives you the formulas that you will need for the exam. So don't forget about this resource. It is there for you to use at all times. It's there for you to use in your works cited page, on your final paper. It's there for you to use for this exam, all that. Don't worry, there won't be any MLA questions on the final exam. We're just doing one final exam to cover MLA this week, and then I'll basically test your knowledge with your works cited page on your final paper. So that's module 7. That's finals week. You just got those 3 assignments and working on your paper. Obviously, the reading response and the MLA exam will probably not take you very long to do. I want the focus to be on your paper this week and on the peer review, the discussion forum. But these 2 assignments you can get done pretty quickly. And like I said, Sunday I'll have the final video posted and I'll talk about finals week from there. All right. So that's pretty much all the assignments for this week. If you have any questions, please let me know. I will be in the office most of the week, so if you need anything, just stop by, or you can call me or email, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. But in the meantime, I hope you all have a wonderful week. Please stay safe, take care, and yeah, I'll be back very soon with our final video for English 122.